Hi, my name is Dr. Daniel Cantor, and I'm the president of the Florida Society of Neurology and the medical director of Neurologique, an organization dedicated to patient-centered care, research, and education. That's why it's so exciting for me to be here all week with the MS Foundation on their cruise for people with MS. The theme is me, motivating, educating, and empowering. I'm so happy to also have MS World to be able to broadcast these, not just through the MS Foundation, but also these videos through the MS World. And we hope to see other people broadcast them as well. What we've done on this cruise is we've stopped in four ports in Labadee, Haiti. We've stopped in Jamaica. We've stopped in the Grand Caymans, and then finally in Cozumel. What we've heard are lectures that have to do with rehabilitations, lectures that have to do with jobs and seeking employment, lectures that have to do with exercising your way, not just exercising my way or somebody else's way. We've also heard a few talks from me. What I focused in these talks was about quality of life and how to improve it. Also, how to communicate with your physician. How to better be the center of the MS team in the MS team approach rule, or MSTAR. Then we also discussed some of the invisible versus visible symptoms of multiple sclerosis. We use various examples such as cognition, thinking, tremors, being in a wheelchair, pain. We also talked about mood and affect. Now, mood means what you're feeling inside, what other people can't see. Affect is how you display that mood. Normally those two things go together, but sometimes in something called pseudobulbar affect or PBA, there can be this disconnection between the mood and the affect and how you display it. This could be problematic because you may have inappropriate bouts of crying and or laughing. And that means that people may look at you funny and say, well, what's going on? And so it's important to think about the different symptoms you're having, to prioritize them, and to discuss them with your neurologist. If you're okay with your tremors, there's no point in me spending a lot of time on the tremors. But if you're not okay with your mood or with your affect, how you display your mood, that can be an issue as well. Finally, I talked about expanding the arsenal of MS treatments. That doesn't only mean in terms of disease-modifying agents, so in terms of the medications we have now, so we have interferon beta-1a intramuscular once a week, Avonex. We have interferon beta-1b every other day, both as beta-seron as well as Xdivane under the skin. And now we have autoinjectors even for the Avonex. Interferon beta-1a subcutaneous 3 times a week with Rebif, which has an auto-injector. We also have glatiramer acetate or Copaxone. There's something called mitoxantrone, which we shy away from a lot, partially because we have a 2-year limitation because of heart disease, but also because 1 in 150 people look like they develop a form of leukemia. And of course, we want to treat our patients. We want to try to minimize the risk that our patients face. There's also IV natalizumab or IV Tysabri, a monoclonal antibody. Remember that when you see mab at the end of the word, it means mono, one, clonal. They're all the same, and antibody is one thing that sticks to another. And that's taken every 28 days, so 12 to 13 times a year. We also have an oral medication called Gileni or fingolimod, which is taken once a day as well. We know in development we have a bunch of new medications, and probably by the end of 2012 or really early 2013, we're going to have 2 new orals, oral BG12 twice a day, as well as oral teriflunomide. Then we're also going to have an IV medicine, IV alemtuzumab, where you get it once a day for 5 days. Followed by nothing for the year, and then once a day for 3 days, and maybe never again, maybe in 2 years, maybe in 5 years, maybe further down the line. So that's exciting. We're having medicines not just compared to placebo, to nothing, but medicines are actually compared to active comparators, to medicines we currently have. We also know about B-cell mediated medications, such as rituximab or the fully humanized version called ocrelizumab, where you take it once, 2 weeks later, 6 months later, and then 2 weeks after that, so only 4 times a year intravenously, so IV. We're learning a lot about different medications. We're learning about a class of medicines that's not for disease modification, but really to improve your quality of life. And those are called neurofunctional enhancers, or NFEs. And what they do is they enhance your neurological function when you have a neurological diagnosis. Some of the issues about this are they have to be tested specifically in MS. And also, we need to see a response fast within a week or two, or three, or four, or really within the first 2 months. And that tells you, well, don't be on the medication if it's not helping you. The first two medications like that, one is called dalfampridine, or Ampira, as well as one called Nudexta, or dextromethorphan and quinidine at low doses. And so we've also seen medicines called duloxetine or Cymbalta that was looked at for MS pain. And then other medicines like Nudexta and like different versions of dextromethorphan plus quinidine being looked at for MS pain as well. And remember, if you want to find out about clinical trials that are near you, what you want to do is go to neurologique.org, so NEUROLOGIQUE.org. And you want to go to the research tab and you want to go to find research near you. You can say what your main diagnosis is. It doesn't have to be MS or migraines. It can be other things. You can also say what your age is. And you don't have to tell me exactly if you're 70 or 72, so don't worry. You have to just do classes of ages, so kids, adults, and then older than adults, so more mature individuals. You can also say what state you're in. And you can also look at what research is going on in general and what research is going on near you so that you can have that access. Even if you don't have an MS doctor, you can have a virtual MS center where you're able to go to physical and occupational therapy and rehabilitation and speech and swallow. You're able to go see a neurologist. You're able to get involved in clinical trials. So we've learned so much in this cruise. It's really been educational. It's really been empowering, and it's really been motivating. It's something I will take home with me, and I will share with the people I treat who have multiple sclerosis as well. So as they say, ships ahoy, and see you next time. Thank you so much for joining us.